Who shot Mario Wood be put on do not know the truth right now. We are demanding the truth. And so with the truth, we're going to bring up our fearless leader, one of our fearless leaders, and that is Mr. Christopher Muhammad of the Nation of Islam.
We are here to say to San Francisco, to Mayor Lee, to the District Attorney, you have an opportunity to heal the wound. The wound, the gaping wound, of the murder of Mario Woods. We have a crisis of confidence now. Chief Suhr has proven that he's not the leader that this department needs. He's not the leader that this city needs to lead this police department. He has fostered a culture of racism, sexism, and a blatant disregard for black life. Even black officers on the department are afraid to step forward because they fear, within the department, retaliation. This is the kind of climate that San Francisco is under the leadership of Chief Greg Suhr, and he must either resign or be fired. If he resigns, he will save this city further embarrassment. As Time magazine has come out and called this Ferguson in San Francisco. Chief Suhr came out and lied to the city, lied to this community, tried to defend the indefensible, tried to make the officers' actions, which were rogue, excessive, improper, and murderous, tried to defend it, then tried video magic to try to show in still photos how Mario Woods attacked the officer. All of these are tactics to try to defend and hide the light and defend rogue actions. That is not the way a chief should operate. That's why he should be fired.
That's right.
Chief Suhr has led a city department with text messages showing that they hate black people, women, people of color. And it took 2 years for this department to investigate itself, showing you there's a culture in SFPD that's rogue in nature. Here's a culture where the Police Officers Association will defend its members even when they're wrong. And Chief Suhr has never corrected, admonished, or rebuked the POA, which means his thinking is in harmony with the POA.
Right.
The POA's tactics of bullying supervisors, black supervisors, bullying community leaders, intimidation, is something that we will no longer stand. This community will challenge the POA and meet it with truth and let them know no more business as usual.
Right.
Mayor Lee is proving to be a weak mayor. To answer the cry of Mario Woods in this community, the answer is not tasers. How dare you offer tasers as an answer? If this department can't manage its guns, can't manage its beanbags, can't manage its pepper spray, why would we give this department more tools to electrocute human beings? If they had tasers with the policy of one shoot, we all shoot, then Mario Woods would probably have been executed or electrocuted with 500,000 volts of electricity. Mayor Lee, you have to listen now to the community. And if you won't do the right thing, at least Rahm Emanuel fired his chief. What are you waiting for? To the DA, we demand that those officers be fired. We demand that the police commission suspend these officers without pay. They don't deserve a vacation for murdering Mario Woods. You don't get a paid vacation for pumping 40 bullets or directing 40 bullets at a young man who's at point blank range offering no threat. So the DA has to do the right thing and learn your lesson from Chicago, Illinois, don't take 13 months to investigate the obvious.
Come on.
It's obvious the young man was murdered.
Yes.
You hurry up and do what you know to do. Otherwise, we'll put you on notice.
Right.
And if you won't do it, Kamala Harris, the Attorney General for the state of California, must do the right thing, because this community needs, deserves, and demands answers for this murder. It will not stand. Thank you.
Thank you, Supervisor.
We don't want changes, though. Let's just keep talking about that. There's a sharp time game going on here. The subject is murder.
Yes.
The subject is what?
Murder.
So in other words, you murder a man, and then you tell him the holster's gone because we're going to give him a taser.
Yes.
Right.
That's called subject before the subject. Of course we need sensitivity training. That's why we have the Bay Area African-American Community Police Relations Board who dealt with that. But this police chief refused to engage this community organization that was dealing with sensitivity training.
Yep.
I'm here to say that we want the chief fired.
Right.
I want to take it to another level.
Right.
I'm thinking that what the chief, if he is going to continue to support open murder in daylight on the streets of San Francisco with the justification that they were following police procedures, then he becomes a conspirator to murder himself, and he doesn't need to be fired. He needs to turn himself in to the DA's office and be booked for murder.
Yeah.
He is guilty as his gang member.
Well,
right.
That's what I want to say.
Right.
Everything else has been plain. We don't have to keep talking about what needs to happen. There's some things that can happen after the chief turn himself in,
yes,
after these murderers are arrested, convicted, sent to prison, yes,
right,
then we can start talking about getting us a new man.
Right.
You know?
Yes.
He can't continue to hide from his responsibility of putting some safety and protection on this city. There's been more murders under his leadership than any other man in history. The police department is corrupt and he needs to sit him down. Hey, anybody seen Ross Mercurini? Will he make a good chief? Think about that.
As we move forward with the People's Press Conference, all the organizations who've been coming to the meeting,
we're coming together, and all the other members of the Maryland Coalition who aren't here. First of all, I just want to express my profound shock, anger, outrage at what's going on, watching the video. How could you do anything else but weep when you see this video? It's your heart and your gut tell you exactly what it looks like went on. And there's no way to counteract with any explanation, any breakdown of the video, what really went on. And the first thing that really the city needs to do and the police department needs to do is to apologize.
Right.
Not to lead to case or some other form of violence that's going to be perpetrated against our community, but an apology and an understanding that something dreadfully wrong happened. Something dreadfully wrong happened. And I hear the community. There's calls of asking the chief to step down or be fired. And I wonder, is that a question that really needs to be answered by the city and by the police commission and by the mayor himself? Did something go wrong? Was something done? Was the way that evidence was presented to the community, was it presented in a way that was false? It kind of looks that way, and there should be an investigation of that.
But it is that way. Chicago, Beverly,
there should be an investigation of that.
South Carolina, how many more?
If you want to build trust with the community that everyone says our policing should be founded on, you don't do things like this. You actually share. You work transparently with the community. You build those relationships. You don't work for the officers to defend officers who are involved in officer-involved shooting first and foremost. No, you have to hear from the community first, and that has not happened over and over and over again. We always lose. The investigation's always done internally with a foregone conclusion. are coming together like this, are uniting with other cities around the country, are really going to make what is going to create the change that we need. It's not just a San Francisco thing, right?
Right.
It's not just a San Francisco thing. The whole country is burning.
Yeah, it's burning.
The whole country is burning.
Right.
So, even if there was an investigation and we changed the leadership of this department, there's so much more change that needs to happen. So whatever fight we have in us because of what's happened here, we need to continue that fight regardless of what happens in the next month, the next 2 months. It's got to be something that lasts long because we have to change this whole criminal justice system, not just in San Francisco, but from top to bottom, from the federal government down to our streets in San Francisco. That's organizing that needs to happen here with so many other places around the country. So I'm committed to that happening. Are you?
Yeah!
I see online people talking about, well, black people kill each other. You know, y'all don't care about us. Y'all here because this is another story. But we hurting out here. We hurting each other because we don't have nothing.
That's right.
We don't have no jobs to go to. We don't have no business owners to raise us and families and stuff like that. You feel me? They savagely murdered him. Target practice. That's what it was. Target practice. You feel me? Our people, we need to wake up.
That's right.
Stand together every day. This ain't just for this week. This ain't just for this month. We can't let another one happen like this. No more.
No more. Unity is strength.
Mario.
Mario.
Every day we need to wake up, look at our people, and love them. It's a wake-up call for us. We need to stand together. Stop waiting for them to take care of us because they're not going to do it.
That's right.
They want to take us.
Tasers ain't gonna do nothing. That's just a new way to kill us.
Yes.
You know what I mean? We out here. We not going nowhere. We screaming justice to Mario Wood. Justice to all our black soldiers that tried to murder in the street.
That's right.
Our demands are simple. We want Chief Sir
fire.
Fire
Chief Sir.
It's an easy way out. That's a sucker's way out. He's still gonna get that picture. We don't want him to get nothing.
Right.
We want to fire the 5+ officers. It was way more than 5 officers.
Ten
we want
up.
All of them brought on charges.
Ten
we want
them
to sit under the jail like y'all do us.
Ten
anytime we shoot somebody, we get charged immediately. It shouldn't take no year or two
ten
to get our charges brought up on them.
Right.
Arrest the officers.
We want the funeral paid for. Put it from the city, reimbursement for all the services that was paid for, and everything like that. And a personal apology to Gwendolyn Wood. Thank you.
And we also want Mayor Lee to come out of hiding.
Come out, Mayor Lee!
Come out. We haven't came out to the community. Come out of hiding, Mayor Lee!
Towards black people, and not only San Francisco, but all over the world. We want to stop the environment that allows a Chief Sir, an Ed Lee, and all these other agencies that have been using our communities as a form of bureaucratic colonialism.
Yes.
We have to stop being their answer to global labor issues. We don't want to feed the prison industrial complex anymore. We don't want to be the race that is called when you talk about human population control. We are tired of being exploited by America.
Yes.
We want accountability from the top down.
Yes.
We don't want to replace somebody just to have them replaced by somebody else that's doing the same thing over and over again. Change the system. Get rid of all the people that are accountable for the things that have happened in our community. And that doesn't stop at Chief Sir. That goes all the way up to the top. Anybody somebody that is elected by us, which means they work for us, if they're not doing the job, needs to resign or be fired.
That's right.
God bless.
But as the brother said, all over this country, because the same thing is happening. We need our people to come together at this time. Take this opportunity to understand that it's a great need that we come as one to fight this monster. We are fighting a monster, a giant monster that we have to deal with. And it does go with the firing or resignation of Chief Suhr as well as Mayor Lee, because he hasn't stepped to this community in no form or fashion except for a vote.
Gentrification.
Thank you again. This is the People's Conference. This is the People's Press Conference where you are going to hear from the people. Our next speaker is Rodney Williams, co-founder of Officers for Justice.
Gentrification.
Oh,
you know the problem.
That's just bringing tight. They want to bring the table. I thought we had settled that a couple of years ago.
Louder.
Justice, for instance, has been opposed to tasers. That's our position. And for me, personally, I have a solution. And I figure that if they put two shields in the trunk of every police car, we wouldn't need tasers. We would shield, and people who know how to operate. And I wish that we could confer with the mayor of San Francisco to talk about some of the problems we're having in our community. So,
gentrification.
Let's support shields as opposed to tasers. Thank you.
And fire chief, sir.
They're coming from Oakland because this is a national problem. This is not just a San Francisco problem. This is a national problem that the police are gunning down our young brothers and sisters.
Gentrification, help, they kill you.
Members of the press and community, I stand before you very much as we stood in 2009 on the steps of the Alameda County Courthouse. To my right is Uncle Bobby Cephas Johnson, the uncle of Oscar Grant, that while we stood on that day to demand that everyone in position of authority in the city and county of Oakland and Alameda County do their part, we're very clear what must be done here in San Francisco.
Yes, sir.
We would say, a sir, no sir.
Right.
No, sir.
No
police chief named Sir in San Francisco.
No, sir. Right.
So
no,
we
sir.
Would say, sir, no,
no sir.
Sir,
sir, no,
it's
sir.
A shame and a travesty that an officer of the law, without investigation, looking at a YouTube clip, would come to the full defense of his murderous staff.
Right.
He's compelled by duty to investigate every homicide. The blood that ran through his veins was not red. The blood that ran through his veins was blue. So while we stand here at the county courthouse, we want to know, what is the district attorney intending to do?
Right, right.
Every murder must be investigated.
Yes.
Every murder must be prosecuted. We were told by former District Attorney Tom Orloff that there was a special relationship between law enforcement and the DA's office.
It is. Yes.
We don't need any further special relationship.
That's right. Yes, sir.
Murder is murder.
Murder
is murder.
Right.
So we say, sir. No,
no,
sir.
Sir. No, sir.
And if the mayor does not understand, then the mayor must be held to account.
Yes.
To the mayor, we say, sir.
No, no sir.
Yes.
When we look at our sister, Kamala Harris,
We're asking that our office
investigate and intervene
immediately.
Yes.
So our sister Harris must know that we have said, sir,
no sir.
So I bring with me my brother, the uncle of Oscar Grant, organizing all over the state of California and all over the country, because all eyes now are on San Francisco. And we should know, while our eyes are here, if black lives do not matter, then your dollars and cents shouldn't matter either.
That's right.
Right.
They're asking us to join the Justice or Else movement to keep your dollars in your pocket.
Yes.
Go downtown and hold on to your money.
Right.
Spend your money after the season is done. Because if our lives do not matter here, then our dollars must not matter here.
That's right.
Keep your money in your pocket. And encourage others to do the same. We are boycotting all Christmas season shopping. If you must spend your money, spend it with black-owned business. Because black lives and black dollars matter too. Please receive Bobby, Uncle Cephas Johnson.
All right, Uncle Bobby.
Don't forget Joe.
Bobby.
Joe's son, 928 Black Stud.
As a member of a family that has suffered the pain and the traumatization that Mario Woods' family has suffered, it's painful. I want you to know that because of the community, as I always say, embracing us, standing with us, crying with us, going back and forth to court with us, but most importantly, utilizing your First Amendment rights and speaking at very injustice of what we saw happen to Mario Woods, because of that community, because of labor getting involved, the ILW Local 10, that is standing with the community, we were able, for the first time in California state history, to get an officer arrested, charged, convicted, and sent to jail.
Yeah.
I say this over and over and over so that we can be clear that we can win this war.
Right.
Yes.
And the common thread that I want to share with you that I see happening all across this nation.
Well,
Chief of the Burke Police Department, who was responsible for Oscar murder, resigned because of the community.
Yes.
Chief of Stanford Police Department resigned because of the community of the murder of Kayvon Martin.
Right.
Chief Beck of the Baltimore Police Department resigned because of the murder of Freddie Gray and the involvement of the community.
Yes.
Yes.
Chief Thomas of the Ferguson Police Department resigned because of the murder of Michael Brown and the community.
Yes,
sir.
Yes,
sir. And the chief in Chicago, as we know just recently, resigned because of the murder of Laquan McDonald.
Yes, sir.
I'm telling you this because if we follow the pattern, of God.
Yes, sir.
We're standing here telling him to resign.
Yes, sir.
But as Minister Christopher said, if he doesn't resign, we will make him resign.
Yes, sir. Right, right.
The only way that's going to happen as a community is that we must stand together, we must speak loud about this, and we must speak on the same point. Chief, sir, you got to go.
Yes, got to go.
Yes, sir.
Chief, sir, got to go.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir, no, sir. Sir, no, sir. Sir, no, sir. Sir, no, sir. Sir, no, sir. Sir, no, sir. Sir, no, sir. Sir, no, sir.
Yes, sir. He's got to go.
A 23-year-old black man who was my only child, who received 48 bullets inside of the Metreon 14 years ago.
Idris!
What has changed? Absolutely nothing.
What's going on?
For my hermanos y hermanas here, I'm going to articulate the demands in Spanish, okay?
Okay.
And that's what he will say is, we want Sir out of San Francisco.
Yes,
and
sir!
We want the five assassins of Mario upstairs on the seventh floor here. Okay? Para el jefe fuera!
El jefe fuera!
El jefe fuera!
Yo no sé si
Arriba.
No, sir.
Yes. No, sir. Ted is building down and built some apartments. Jonestown, they've been mugging us for a while. Tell the truth. Gentrification.
The mayor needs to get on top of this right now. Right now. I would really like to see him indicted because what he's doing, he's obstructing justice, he's harboring, and he's aiding and abetting a murder and murderer.
Murder.
And you know what I mean? We really need to have him indicted.
Gentrification!
And so with that, one of the organizers who are supporting this is Service Employees International Union, who has given us a space. We are Justice for Mario Woods Coalition. And so here we have a representative from SEIU who wants to say a few words.
Good morning, sisters and brothers. My name is Valoria Russell Benson. I am a healthcare industry chair, and I am on the board of SEIU Local 10-1. I am sickened by the murders that's going on in this family, this city.
Yes,
and I am sick and tired of every time we turn around, the officers are murdering our children.
Yes.
This has got to stop.
Yes.
Sir, no, sir, I say it again.
Yes.
Sir, no, sir.
Yes.
Mayor Ed Lee needs to step up and apologize to the family.
Yes.
He needs to step up and stand out and let these families know that he has their support instead of the officers.
Yes.
And on...
Recall him. Recall him.
Yes, recall him.
Recall him.
Recall him. He's just next.
So I give my prayers and support on this behalf of SEIU Local 10-1. For the families of all the young men that have been involved.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Bar Chief, sir.
We are going to continue. As I said, we are holding strong to be consistent and a sustainable movement. In a moment, we get angry, but a movement takes time.
That's right.
And we have already began to get the ear of the powers at B.
We do.
So clap it up. Powerful people.
We do.
Powerful people,
we
clap
do.
It up.
We do.
We have just got word that G.A. Gascon wants to come and speak with us.
Good.
And so we want answers. And after he speaks to the crowd, we, the Justice for Mario Woods Coalition, will be going to his office to sit down and talk with them about our concerns. And our concerns and our demands is fire Chief Suhr,
yes,
and the officers who murdered,
murdered
and executed Mario Woods by firing squad. They need to be brought up on charges.
Yes.
D.A. Gascon, we welcome you, and we are anxious to hear what you got to say. Come on, D.A.
Thank you. You know, I just want to be very, very brief.
Prosecute George.
I want...
Stop gentrification!
Okay, would you please listen up?
Organize and strategize and mobilize.
The first thing that I think is really important, that we all recognize that a human being lost his life.
Gentrification!
And...
Stop it.
And... This is an area
that's why we're here,
that I and every man and woman that works in the District Attorney's office takes very seriously. I can assure you that we are conducting a fully independent investigation into this case. I can assure you that we will look at every piece of the law and every piece of evidence.
Kill the people because they ain't got no house.
Determine,
you know what you're doing.
This whether this brother, case is a case that can be prosecuted or not.
Show.
But I want to again underline.
This shit been going on for 10 years.
Really need to get up.
Come out here now.
Talking about a person who
you
lost
their life. They kill transgenders. They kill black people. And the people who kill them.
They kill sure black. We respect that. Again, I'm going to say it once again. My office is conducting a fully independent investigation.
All together.
We will examine every piece of evidence. We will make the conclusions of our investigation
fully
hurry it up,
public. It will be a transparent process. I will meet with some of you today, later on today. I will continue to be available to you to talk about this case or any other case. What I ask of you is that you continue to act as you're acting today. It is important to state your freedom of expression, and it's important that we all act in the way that we're acting today. I encourage you to continue to do this. But again, know that this will be a fully transparent investigation. You will know
when we conclude
what was the evidence available, what does the law say about the evidence, and we will walk you through our conclusion, whatever that conclusion is, and I have no idea what that will be today. Again, you also need to know that we have to look at it through a lens of the law. And the laws that we have available.
Dangerous.
Okay?
President Obama.
I want you to be completely assured of the transparency of the investigation, the thoroughness of the investigation, and the independence of the investigation.
We can get mad, but we're going
to
get killed.
Talking to some of you later on today,
but
I also want to say that I hope that we look at this as the beginning of the dialogue and not just simply standing here today and talking to you.
I could use
the
help.
The beginning of the
stop gentrification! Stop to the Bayview! Stop to the Bayview!
Stop gentrification!
Stop to the Bayview!
Stop gentrification!
Stop gentrification! 10 versus 1! 10 versus 1! 10 versus 1!
I am!
10 versus 1!
Like you! Let's make it clear, we came here for simple demand. Why are we here? Charge the officer. No taser. That's clear.
Then the one.
So now since the DA, George Gascon, has spoken, we have work to do. To hold him accountable to every word he just uttered. Whether he's going to the state, whether he's going to the federal government,
We
thank you for coming out.
No more
we appreciate this.
Gentrification is racist. Gentrification is the new racism.
I'm going to leave this note right here, and this is my motivation.
Alex!
I heard my whole Woods mama say. She said, the men that killed my son, I sleep at night, and I know they feel the same pain that I feel. Because I was murdered. And I'm here to spread that right there for my elders, all organizations. I appreciate y'all being here because history repeats itself. History repeats itself and y'all know better because y'all been through this.
Yes.
So I appreciate y'all. Y'all will be seeing my face. Show me
we
how to
do
better. Because I'm here to listen and learn.
Everybody's involved. Everybody.
That's right. All right, we're going to bring up Reverend Amos Brown, the president of the NACP. And we want to assure Amos Brown we are serious. And we want justice. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace. No justice, no peace.
My brothers and sisters, that Chief Sir should receive a resounding no, sir.
No, sir.
I'm sure you remember that 50 years ago, there was a series that came on television called Dragnet.
Yes.
And Joe Friday often went into situations. And in the midst of investigating the situation, someone would say, I think, I heard, or it looks like to me. But always, Joe Friday would say, just the facts, ma'am. Just the facts, ma'am.
Just the facts.
As president of the NACP of San Francisco, I have arisen to give you the facts as to why Chief Sir should receive a no, sir.
Okay. No, sir. All right.
1 year ago, fact number one. There was a witness who knew these facts, standing right next to me, Archbishop Franz O'Keefe, NACP, along with faith leaders and other community-based organizations, met with the chief of staff of the city. The chief of police was there. And I said in that meeting, Chief, Ferguson is in San Francisco. But this chief stood up on the floor and took issue with my comment and said, oh no, this is liberal, progressive San Francisco. But I looked him square in the eye and I said, Chief, I know Ferguson is in Missouri. And I know that demographically and geographically, we are here on the Bay in San Francisco. But in terms of attitude, in terms of practices, San Francisco is living a lie. Ferguson is in San Francisco. For that reason, the chief will not face the facts. And he needs to be released from his position.
Right.
He does not deserve to be there.
Oh,
if he cannot admit the fact that this city is racist, that this city stops young black men proportionally more so for jaywalking than any place in the city. The next fact is our young people have been stopped and harassed in this city. Police have come to my church at 1:45 in the afternoon and told a gumbo band at a funeral where people were grieving, we were keeping up too much noise. Thanks be to God. I stood and gave the case 1 year ago that this city is racist, and since the chief has not owned up to the facts, he must go.
No, no, sir.
Thank you, Reverend Amos Brown.
All right.
And now we want to bring up someone who's been with the family. Sean Richards, come on up, brother.
Hey,
yeah.
Good afternoon. I just
just recently got off the phone with the mom about 5 minutes ago, and she told me to tell you thank you, God, you know, and keep his name alive. But I just want to say a couple of things real quick regarding the POA, the mayor's office, and the mayor's office. I'm sorry, my mind is gone right now. You know, it's been a lot. The mayor's office, the POA, and chief of police. If you guys heard what they was talking about, shields and stun guns, that's not going to help our community. But if you notice in his comments, in all three of their comments, not one time did they mention about the community. They never mentioned the community. The other point that we need to make is that Bayview Station is a training facility. And we need to change that. We need to get more black officers over in that community that's dealing with that community, that's up at arms, that's in our own community, to work with our community. So the more we keep doing this, the more we're going to get the word out. You heard this brother behind me just said, it can't be just today, tomorrow. And Ms. Christopher Muhammad said yesterday, Mario's life was sacrificed. So if it was sacrificed, then that means we got to sacrifice our life.
That's right.
And stand up for what's right.
Stand up for what's right.
So we can't just do this today.
That's right.
It got to be tomorrow. Right. Next Wednesday, we got to be at the police commission meeting doing the same thing we've been doing. Every single week, show up and show out. And if not, we're going to shut this city down.
Shut it down.
No justice, no peace.
Now we're going to bring up one of our Latino brothers. Come on up, because we're joining first forces with our Latino community, Mr. Ed Linda.
I want to first start off by thanking everyone that's here. I want to thank the pastors, churches, Felicia for your leadership. But we're here right now because this brother is laying dead as a result of an execution.
That's right.
We have to be very clear, and I think our police chief has to be very clear, that we have a system that is inherently racist.
That's right.
And we cannot deny it. We can't hide it. The numbers show it.
That's right.
The number of people of color in this prison, the number of people of color that are dead as a result of the badge.
Oh, man.
I went to middle school with this brother right here.
Yes, sir.
I went to Martin Luther King Middle School. But yet, every day, we strive just to survive, just to stay alive. Our struggle should not just to be staying alive. Our struggle should be to thrive.
That's right.
And our communities are being let down every single day. And I'm telling you right now that unless we stand up as we are right now, they're going to continue to walk over us. They're going to continue to do it. And I'm going to tell you this, that the coalition we're bringing, unfortunately, is taking the lives of way too many of our brothers and sisters for us to come together. But we're here. We're here today. We will stand with you tomorrow. We have the Mission Peace Collaborative, which is the Latinos in the mission, that are saying this has to stop, and it has to stop today. We can't let another one, because there's been too many sacrifices. At what point do we say the sacrifices are enough? I said we said that 6 years ago. We said that 20 years ago. We said that when folks were walking across the bridge so they can get their right to vote. We need to stop. 2014, December 13th, we had the Millions March. Felicia helped organize. I helped organize. We were there. We had 5,000 people marching from the Ferry Building to City Hall. And what were we demanding? That our young black and brown folks stop being killed. And a year later, we're still here. We're demanding the exact same thing. We're tired of it. We're tired of it, and I will stand with you in solidarity, and I will stand behind you, and I hope that we continue this fight. And all we ask for is there has to be systemic change. And I know through the folks here today, we can make it happen, but we have to be united, and we can't be separated, and we can't be divided. Love. Peace.
All right, and then also one of the organizations with Justice for Mario Woods Coalition is our Asian community. Come on up here, Jay, and say a word.
All right, how you doing today?
All right.
All right.
Yeah.
I'm from the Fillmore, from the Midtown Public Apartment Complex. We're sitting here united with our brothers and sisters from Bayview Hunters Point to the Mission to Western Addition.
All right.
Because there is a very systematic pushed to push out communities of color. Black community is down to 3% in this city, and they make up 57% of the criminal justice system. I say that's wrong. We need to empower our black community. We need to cherish, preserve, and expand the last 3%. And how do we do that? We need to make sure the folks did not get pushed out from their homes, that they have affordable houses, that there is no gentrification and banishment from the city that your folks helped build. We're asking to fire Chief, sir. We say that black lives matter.
Sir, no, sir.
Preserve the last 3%.
So we're going to be winding down on what my sister Sala and my other sister who's on the Justice for Mario Woods Coalition to come up.
I wrote something last night, and I just want to read it to you, and watch out for the threat of terrorism. Terrorism is nothing new to me. My people have been living with terror for generations.
Right.
Those that terrorize my community, they don't wear suicide vests.
Right.
They wear blue uniforms.
Bulletproof vests.
Those that terrorize my people do not scream of jihad. They scream free. Hands up.
Right.
Those that terrorize my community do not threaten beheading. They threaten incarceration, illegal search and seizure, and falsified evidence. And they do not threaten to disrupt the American way. They remind black and brown Americans they do not deserve to live that dream. Yesterday, the president was on my TV telling me in order to prevent another terrorist attack, we must be vigilant. We're constantly reminded, if you see something, say something. And here I am thinking to myself, wait a minute. I saw something. I should say something.
Right.
There's been an act of terror in my hometown. Right. And on December 2nd, 2015, there was an act of terror committed right here in San Francisco's Bayview District by those that took an oath to serve and protect, an oath they long forgot. Mario Woods was publicly executed in a manner that was just as brutal as any beheading uploaded to YouTube. He stood against a wall, distraught, confused, and disoriented. He was afraid. And as he stood there, beaten down by rubber bullets and pepper spray, he was beleaguered by five terrorists dressed in blue who riddled his body with more than 20 bullets. So I've seen it. We've all seen it.
Yes, we have.
And now it's time for us to say something. We've seen something. We must say something. Now it's time for all of us to come together, be vigilant, and let SFPD know we will not be terrorized anymore. No more terror.
Okay, come on up, my sister Sala.
Last one. Power to the people! Watch up here today. In the name of Yahweh our Elohim, of the ancient Tetragrammaton, a Hebrew queen standing in your possession, whose son was murdered. When I saw Mario, he reminded me of my son, of your son, of your son, of your son. And when you start putting it in your mind that these are our children.
Right.
These are our responsibility, these babies walking on the street. It is evil and wickedness to see our children massacred and murdered in our presence, and we don't stand. I'm thankful as a mother. I say to the women, and I say to the mothers, myself, and organizing in Bayview Hunter's Court, EMP, in the name of empowering my people, the main one revolution, the main number one revolution. It is the mothers that need to take their position. Minister Christopher is representing the brothers, but we need the women and the mothers to take a stand, because we are tired of seeing our brothers being murdered on the street. We are tired of the racial profile. We are tired of the harassment. We are tired of the lies and the cruelty. And as I have learned wisdom and knowledge and most of all an understanding, it's a time and a place for every day, for everything. And this is the time and this is the place for us to unite as one people. And I want to thank Felicia for standing as a woman. I know you're tired. We all tired,
that's
sister.
Right.
I'm here for you. I'm here for. I want you to know. I've been over there organizing in Bayview on this point, but I've been sending my people your way because every one of us must stand in their position.
Right.
I give respect and credit what credit is due. I step back. I'm not trying to be up here. The people are asking me to come and speak, but I want you to know. I love. It's time for us. It's time for us to help one another,
right,
so we can be strong
right.
And to help the brothers. Because remember this, to every strong man, there's a woman. Remember that. All right, so we're going to get ready to close because we are going to be meeting with D.A. Gascon at 3 p.m. So all of the organizers with Justice for Maria Woods Coalition, see myself and Minister Christopher afterwards so we can see who is all going up. But until, I want to say this.
I am Mario Woods.
Right, we are Mario Woods, and what happened to him happened to all of us. We will have a follow-up meeting on Monday at 6 p.m. at Service Employees International Union, Local 1021. The address is 350 Rhode Island. The easiest way to get in is to enter on Kansas Street. If you're serious about justice for Mario, you will meet us all there, 6 p.m., SEIU, 1021 on Monday, this Monday. We are not stopping. We do not have time to put a whole lot of time in between to get back together. We gonna keep this movement going. It's gonna be consistent, and this movement is sustainable. So if you believe, or if you think that we are going anywhere, we're not going nowhere, because we're not begging, we're not asking, we are demanding justice.